Well, as you all know, winter has arrived, and along with it, the colds and flus. Eating healthy is one way to try and keep from getting sick, but making soups and blending fresh juice can be rather consuming. Time-consuming, at least. Well, nzgirl.co.nz editor Tee Twyford is here with a bunch of gadgets to try and make that a bit easier.
Definitely.
Hello there.
Hi, Pippa.
Let's start with this. Here. I'll hold it up. It's got greenery in it.
It is. This is the... There's two gadgets or technology integrated pieces I bought in that help you keep fresh herbs in the kitchen. I don't know about you, but I always buy those fresh herbs from the supermarket and within a day they've died, so I should have just bought the cut and dried ones anyway. This is the Prepara Herb Saver. So you take your sort of chopped herbs. You can either buy them like that or I guess chop them from the living things.
Oh.
And then put them inside the basket, put it in here, and then there's a whole lot of water in the bottom, so it's just keeping the ends
and
alive.
And then this keeps in the fridge.
Yeah, and then it just fits in the fridge door.
And does it works quite well?
Seems to work. Those have only been in since last night, but the tests that they had sort of said that it lasts about 2 to 3 weeks in the fridge.
Okay,
which is far more than my 2 to 3 days.
I'm the same, probably depending on which herbs you're talking about, but yeah, a few days. This doesn't fit a heck of a lot of herbs in it, though.
I think you could condense quite a few in there.
You could probably squish them down.
Yeah.
How much?
That one is the larger size, so $69.99.
And it just slips in the fridge door. Yeah, I guess if you're using all the time.
Alternatively, if you're in, if you're wanting to actually...
like this, big test. Doesn't look that flash, does it?
No, but this is a Kiwi designer, Patrick Morris, who, yes, there we go. It's created an upside down planter. So this one's really great because it doesn't use as much bent space. You know, if you want to keep that clutter-free edge going on. And then in the top, it's got a little space to water with the terracotta. So you put the water in there and then it just sort of gradually filters through across the month and keeps it all.
Is there any way that this is actually going to keep your herbs better as opposed to if it was just sitting on the bench? It's kind of gimmicky.
I think it kind of looks good.
It does look
quite cool. I think that's kind of the angle it's going for.
Yeah, having said this, I've seen some quite cool flowers presented like this. And I guess you could use it for anything, couldn't you?
Yep, and just great about it, you know, trim across in the kitchen
when
you're
cooking. Well, that's true, and then you don't get the whole droopy parsley thing.
Yep, yeah. No, definitely.
And $50 for that.
Yes, and it comes in a couple of sizes as well. Yeah. So that's from Simon James.
I do quite like it, Simon James Design. Okay, we're getting into the more expensive category
now. I know, something jumping
up. And the juicer here.
Yes.
Now, it looks nice, I'll give it that.
It does, got the nice chrome finish.
What is different about this juicer from any other juicer that you would get on the market?
Yeah, I was talking to friends in Sydney. It seems that juice detoxes are all the rage over there. And the difference being that they use what's called a single gear or cold press or masticating juicer. So instead of it being... Sounds a bit like fifth-form biology, doesn't it?
Doesn't it?
back to, you know, the typical juicer would spin around really, really, really fast and kind of separate the pulp from the juice.
Yes.
But apparently the process of doing that, the heat ends up killing all the good enzymes within your living juice.
Knew?
So this one operates far slower. You put, obviously, your carrots, your apples, your wheatgrass in there. It's spinning around, it's really quiet, and then the juice is coming out here and it's pushing the pulp out the other end.
And it does a good job? Hmm? Slow? Is it easy to clean?
Yeah, that's the brilliant thing about it is there's not very many parts. So there's kind of four different parts in there. Take them apart, wash them with soapy water and put away. And this doesn't even need
It looks cool, and you'd happily have it on your bench.
Yeah.
Now, if we can get a shot of this one. This here, let me start by telling you how much this costs. And you can feel it in its weight. Nearly $2,500 for this gadget, which is a...
Thermomix.
What?
It's pretty much like the Rolls Royce of kitchen appliances. I am not looking forward to giving it back. This I came across because it was on Australian MasterChef. I've since found out it's in most of the kitchens of the 5-star restaurants around Auckland, but it's also great for an absolute dunce. I made risotto last night, which is my least favourite thing to cook because you've got to always watch it, it's burning, you've got to stir it.
You can basically do anything in here. You can, everything that a normal food processor would do, plus you can...
Bread maker, rice maker, made sorbets, it's got scales on it that let you weigh, it's got... You know, a blender that goes at different speeds, it's got a stirrer, it's got an element as well, so you can be cooking.
Okay, so if you are looking for an absolutely everything device, it feels solid, it's probably going to last a long time, that would be what you were after.
Definitely. Amazing. Probably my favourite this year.
I can still smell the risotto from last night as well. Tee, thank you very much for joining us this morning.
So if you are obsessed with masticating, that would be the machine for you.
Definitely.
Yes. Yeah.
Although maybe not, because that takes all the masticating out of the process, really,
so Paul. Actually, you'd get one of those and you'd never masticate again.
No.
So, if, now, let me just say, in London, providors, which is... They have these all along the front. Oh, they have all of these along the front. Yeah.
With herbs hanging out.
Wonderful Peter Gordon's restaurant.
Yes.
And they have them. I'm not sure that they have herbs, actually. Herbs. Who says that? I'm not sure that they have herbs in them, but they have sort of plants and things like that. But what would happen, I think, is your parsley would actually grow up.
No.
No, I think it would.
I don't think it would.
I'll do a test, Paul, and I'll
Well, I think it would. Could you do a test? Could you just do a test, Tee? Thank you.
Right, for more information on Tee's gadgets, do visit nzgirl.co.nz.
Yeah, but you can't say gravity, because if that was gravity, it would just be like that, wouldn't it, all the time?
Well, it's trying to get there, isn't
it? Have you not seen parsley on a bench? Look at it. It's already getting there.
Yeah, I know, but it shouldn't be like that. I think it will grow the other way. Anyway, you're going to do a test, Tee.